All right, next one. President-elect Trump, one of his main campaign platforms was America's poor relationship with China. Remember all the times that Mr. Trump slammed Beijing. Oh, watch this.
What China has done to our country is the biggest theft and the greatest theft in the history of the world.
This is the one I didn't want to hear. Give me China. Give me China.
China. You ever see China's tone?
China.
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 We don't win anymore. When was the last time we won? We lose to China.
Well, hold on a second. Despite the pronunciation of China, it seems that Mr. Trump's popularity in China is rising. I don't get it, but Gordon Chang does. He's the author of the book, The Coming Collapse of China. He's back. What is going on? Why? Which group, which sector of the Chinese population likes Donald Trump?
Almost everybody but Xi Jinping, the ruler of the country.
Look, you're kidding. Why?
He's the outsider. He's the one who's accessible, who's open, who speaks his mind, who throws convention to the wind. And, you know, Chinese leaders, on the other hand, they're very close. They've got one press conference a year in March where they take scripted questions and read answers. You know, Trump is just fresh. And that's why it's so important, I think. You know,
how do you know that Trump is popular in China? What newspaper, which magazine, which Facebook posting are you reading?
You don't see Weibo, and of course Facebook is not permitted in China.
Right.
But you do see a lot of the Chinese Twitter-like platforms like WeChat, Weibo. So those types of things, you can see comments that people talk about Trump. And by the way, there is this story, which I don't know if it's true or not, but it does said that the Communist Party held an election for its People's Congress in Shanghai. And this is very scripted because there's only Communist Party members running and all the winner is chosen in advance. Well, there was supposedly 10% of the people in Shanghai wrote in Donald Trump's name and 6% wrote in a Japanese porn star. So you can see that there's a lot of discontent. So it's not just about Trump, it's about the Communist Party.
Okay, now let's reverse this for a second. Donald Trump is probably going to push hard on China. Do you think that will make China retreat into nationalism, dangerous nationalism within China as a response to Trump?
Well, they've already retreated into a dangerous form of nationalism under Xi Jinping. And that is a continuation of what his predecessor, Hu Jintao, is doing. But under Xi, it's actually accelerated. So Trump is going to face a very difficult time. Even in the best of circumstances, Chinese leaders test new American leaders. April 2001 for George W. Bush,
right,
and March and May 2009 for President Obama. So, you know, Trump is going to get a hard time from the Chinese leaders, especially because they know that he has said all those things about China, and so therefore they want to defang him quickly before he can do real damage to their fragile economy.
I'm dying to see how this plays out, because it actually could be a very dangerous situation.
It could be.
Gordon, come back and tell us how it's playing out, please. Gordon Chang, everyone. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks, Stuart.